young German long-haired pointer down to the lake to try and introduce him to water. He's not that keen, so it's going to probably take quite a lot of effort to get him in. But the first thing is to take him in the shallow water. Get him confident about the element of water. He's confident in there before we ask him to swim. You can see he's not sure. But all the time, I'm drawing him back. I don't want him running off around the lake. I want him to realise he's got nowhere else to go. But we're not going to make him do it. We want to encourage him in. He's not prepared to follow me in, so we're going to use a bribe. He's a keen retriever, so this is going to be the weapon we're going to try and get him in with. See, he's got his front feet wet now, so we've made a little bit of progress. The delivery is not there. He's dropped the ball. Sometimes you just have to sacrifice little bits and pieces to get what you want out of the dog. And today, the aim is to get the dog in the water. And if we lose something else along the way, it's probably not the end of the world with him because he's a strong retriever. He has a good delivery. So hopefully we won't lose too much. And again, I'm being fairly quick at getting in there and trying to get the ball off him before he drops it. Because we don't want to lose any of his training during this process. But you see now he's coming in the water, still very tentative, but he's making an effort. He's walking out. The ball is just close enough to draw him out, and that's what we're working at. And again, I'm going forward fairly quickly to take the retrieve from him so he doesn't get into the habit of dropping it. So he's starting to enjoy himself now, slowly getting a little bit more confident, but still not ready to go swimming. And gradually what we'll do is drop the ball out a little bit further each time. And quite often we'll just throw it up and down the shallows just to get him running through the water so he'd get used to the splashing. You see now he's just going out a little bit more eagerly now, right up to his chest. So we're making a little bit of progress, and it's each bit at a time. But again, calling him out, don't let him go off and do anything else. Don't let him think he can go off and play or go hunting. It's all about keeping his focus here with me in the water and getting him out. Again, he's keen to get to it, but I think that might be too far. Just hasn't got that confidence yet. He wants it, but he's not, doesn't want it that much. He hasn't got the confidence to his feet to come off the ground. Again, putting another one out in front of him, try and draw him out. Again, just a few inches too far. He hasn't got the courage to take that final leap. But if you notice, I'm putting several balls out just all the time, trying to keep him out there until eventually he'll launch and go for it. You can see he's still not confident, not balanced in the water. He still needs something a bit easier. But he noticed all the time I'm in the background encouraging him, keeping pushing him out there. Keep going, never give up. And then an easy one, just to give him a bit of a carrot, just to encourage him so he thinks he can do it. And that's what we're trying to teach him, the confidence to know he can do it. So just one or two easy ones again, just bring him back on side. And this is why a lake is better than a river, because the dummies that he hasn't got, all the balls, they'll float around. We'll get them later on. Obviously, in a river, you're in trouble because they'll float away.
Good boy. Good lad.
Again, that's another easy one. But he's still getting the water nearly over his shoulders, so he's getting the feel of the water all over him, and that's what we're trying to do, just all the time, build him up. One of the other things you have to watch with tennis balls is when they hold them in their mouth, it allows the water in the sides of their mouth, so just be a bit careful. They end up putting themselves off by swallowing a bit of water. So just to say, they're right to get them going, but when they come to advanced water work, they really need to have a dummy rather than a ball.
Fetch it, fetch it, fetch it. Where's he going? Fetch it, fetch it, fetch it. Where's he going? Fetch it.
Again, just a little bit too far for him. He doesn't really seem to have the courage yet. What I'm going to do now is just pick up a stone and throw it near the dummy to get a splash. Just try and draw him out again. Just try and encourage him to keep going. Don't throw a stone out for the dog if there's nothing out there, because obviously it will sink and he'll get no reward for going out there. See, he's actually swimming now, but he hasn't got the courage to keep going. That's why I was encouraging him, telling him how clever he was, because he actually swam then, but he frightened himself. So again, we'll just try make a splash near the dummy, keep his attention out there, but he's still struggling. Got an added problem now. There's some geese coming in. And because this young dog's very keen on game, they're going to distract him, which is going to cause us a problem. If we can't... See, now they've come and landed on the lake. He's watching those. So that's not going to help the situation. If we don't get success fairly quickly, we're going to need to stop, because otherwise we're going to lose his focus. You see, he's not so bothered about that dummy. He's having a bit of a go, and he's swimming. Yep, he's got it. That's fantastic. Little step, he's swimming with it in his mouth. And that's what we've tried to achieve. And I think with the way things are now, bad delivery, I think at this stage it's probably best to pack up.